commercial.
Did you?
Yeah? What did you see? Did you see one? No? Maybe? What do the girls look like?
More round.
More curvy and thick, right?
Not
and
me.
That's what we talked about,
tight
right?
Clothes.
Yeah. What about the guys, though? Were they like the six pack and all that?
No,
not at all, right?
They were smart.
They were like.
They were nerdy.
They were kind of nerdy.
What's wrong
yeah.
with being a nerd?
They're kind of like nerdy
girls
science.
Had like really like tight clothes.
One was a stoner.
Tight clothes.
What?
Yeah. Well, is he like a Rastafari, not necessarily a stoner?
Whoever made that commercial was a stoner.
Okay.
All smart people. Are
so do you guys think? Do you guys notice what song
ideas.
Was playing?
Animals.
What's that whole song about?
About intercourse.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's
that?
Sexual activities. Yes. It was right. So it's basically just I'm gonna come and get you and do with you what I want you to what I want to do, right?
Yeah.
Dang it, Adam.
Yeah.
What'd you say?
I said, dang it, Adam.
I know. Dang it, Adam. Okay. So do you all think that when we see things like that, like it's kind of a funny commercial, it's clever, like. It would be really exhausting if everything we heard or everything we saw, we like observed and we like thought that critically about everything, right? We can't do that. But do you think if we see these kinds of messages that reinforce stereotypes that aren't really okay, do you think that it affects us at all?
Yeah.
Yeah? I think it does, right? Because think about how many messages we're taking in all the time. If we're on our phones all the time, we're on social media, TV, right? And then just being out like, around our friends or family, like we're constantly getting messages. And so if we're constantly seeing or hearing these kinds of messages, it kind of shapes how we feel and how we think. Not that we think about it, we may not realize it's happening, but it does shape how we think and feel about things, right?
Yeah.
So we know that there's a connection between stereotypes and sexual violence, okay? We know that women get sexually assaulted more often than men, okay? So there's that connection between maybe there's a connection between men being taught that dominance or aggression is how they should express themselves, and women are taught the opposite, that you shouldn't fight back, you shouldn't really assert yourself. And so, again, it's not that all men are bad or all women are bad. That's not what this is about. It's just about how we can, like, how we are socialized. Because most of us want to have good relationships and just want to have a good time and then, like, enjoy our lives. We don't intentionally, like, think about these things. But if we do think through them and know that there are influences out there, sometimes we can reverse them. Does that make sense? Maybe? Okay. Do you guys have any other thoughts or any questions? Or maybe disagree with that? Okay. I know. Crickets. Perfect. It's kind of a weird topic. I get that. Tomorrow, though, we're going to talk about dating violence. That's fun, too. And it's really interactive. We're up talking. Everybody's talking to one another the whole time. So we'll talk about, like, relationship dynamics. But, yeah, so just know that Mox is here. If y'all ever need anything, we work with anybody who is, like, experiencing suicidal ideation or experiencing domestic violence or sexual violence. So if you ever need help or you need to know how to help somebody that you care about, you just don't know where to start or you're, like, overwhelmed, that's normal when you've experienced trauma. So you can always call Moxa anonymously, and we can help you. Even if it's just like you want to call and just talk to somebody because you just really don't know what to do, we are not going to ask for your name or require that you give us your name or your information. You can call anonymously. We just want to be there as a support to help you out if you want help, if you need help, okay? And our phone number for our crisis line is on this red sheet up here, so you can always grab it anytime. Or go online and find us. But yeah, remember all of our services are free. And you can call the crisis line 24/7, like literally 2 in the morning on Christmas if you needed to, and somebody would answer the phone, okay? So we're here. That's all I have. I'll be back tomorrow. Thank you guys.
Welcome.
That's it. If you have personal questions, I'm up here. I'm happy to answer them. But thank you.
That was actually fun.
Yes,
it wasn't actually.